I had sushi last night, actually, here in New York. But the fisheries are closed that are the most affected, and the types of fish off Japan. So there are checks on that. Certainly, they've increased the checks, like the FDA in this country. But still, there can be holes. So I think we really have to hope and ask the questions of the people who are monitoring fisheries in Japan and making sure that fishermen aren't coming into the areas that are closed, that there's a regular monitoring both, you know, here and abroad. And the other point that someone asked me later to be careful with is they have the most strict standard, 100 becquerels per kilogram. It's 10 times lower than other countries like the U.S. and Canada. So what they're doing to close the fisheries is 10 times sooner than, say, we would close the same fisheries for the same exposure. It's partly because they eat a lot more fish than we do, so there's good reason to have a more strict standard in that population. It's partly because they wanted to convince the public that it was safe to be eating Japanese foods.
Convince.
And that kind of backfired because the fish didn't go down as fast as they expected.
Yeah. Dr. Starr, dozens of articles falsify the ICRP's radiation risk model or show it to be an error. Hundreds of references in Russian language literature show extraordinary effects from radioactivity on genomic instability, genetic effects in plants and fish, which cannot suffer from radiophobia. Why has this enormous body of evidence been ignored by the ICRP, IAEA, and WHO?
There's an interesting movie called, a video called Nuclear Controversies that I think is worthwhile to watch. And in part of the interactions that take place there, they have a former director of the World Health Organization speaking about how the WHO is subordinate to the International Atomic Energy Agency at the United Nations. The IAEA reports to the Security Council, and they don't. Also, there's a contractual relationship between the World Health Organization and the IAEA, so they, WHO has to have their reports essentially okayed by the IAEA. And in the movie, I spoke of the Dr. Vasily Nestorenko, and I believe one of the esteemed guests that's here is Alexei Yablokov was in the conversation. And they were talking, they were asking why, although it was Michael Freneau, I believe, but he was asking, why is the World Health Organization not accepting the reports 9 years of the research from the scientists and doctors of Belarus about the, you know, 100,000 measured whole body counts and 300,000 foodstuffs that have been measured? And what he said was, well, we can't accept that information unless it comes from the government. If you go to the website of Belarus, it's interesting, there really is very little or almost no mention of Chernobyl, except maybe on a subpage, although when you look at the health statistics like the ones I had on today, you'll see a precipitous drop in the, you know, life. It's like a 19-year drop in life expectancy from 1986 to around 2000. Since then, it seems to be bumping up, but I'm not sure I believe any government statistics anymore from anybody. I get like too cynical. But, you know, so I guess my long answer is just that I think in terms of the World Health Organization and IAEA, there's a problem there, and in terms of WHO being subordinate to the IAEA, and then they also cannot accept the data that I was talking about unless it comes from the government. The government doesn't seem, the same government that puts Yuri Banachevsky in prison for 6 years and tortures him is probably not going to pass his information on to the World Health Organization.
And on that note, Tim,